Now that we've been through a number of different concepts, we've been learning a lot of syntax and different ways to do things, and we've gone through some examples, but I think this is a good time to kind of step back and review, to take a look at everything that we've done at this point and try to tie it together in one program. Because I think what happens a lot of time in programming is that things don't click right off the bat. Sometimes they do, but a lot of times it takes looking at it a second or a third time, and all of a sudden it just clicks. It's like, I know how that fits into everything else now. I get it. And it'll just happen. And so the idea for this example that I'm going to do, kind of a review program, is to go back and, in kind of a more slow, methodical way of doing it than I've been doing in the examples, is to come back and kind of explain every step of what I'm doing in the program. And hopefully, through this process, we'll get a lot of clicking going on, like, oh, I see now. Hopefully, we can tie it all together in this program. Now, I was looking for a program and couldn't think of a good one, and my good buddy Drew gave me this suggestion for this game to write. And the game is an odd-even game. Now, like an odd-even game that I guess I was familiar with, it was you have three players, and then everybody picks a one or a two. And then whoever's the odd person out is the one that's it, that has to do whatever, clean the dishes or whatever it is. The game that he suggested is a game where we say, so there's a user, there's two players. So one player says, I think the number's going to be odd or even. And then at the same time, they throw a one or a two. If the number comes out to be odd and the person picked odd, then they win. If the number comes out to be even and they picked odd, then the person loses. And we can kind of keep track of who wins. And so the idea here is to play a series of these games. So we could say like a best of three, let's say, and then it's almost like a coin flip. You call it odd or even, and then both users throw their number to get the odd or the even number, right? If one picks a two and one picks a one, that's a three, that's odd. And so depending on whether the user picked odd or even, they might win or lose. Okay, so we're getting kind of the concept there. So again, the kind of the first thing I like to do is tackle the pseudocode for the program to kind of work everything out logically. And so I mentioned one of the first things we're going to need to do is ask the user whether they want to pick odd or even as the result. Okay, that's going to be their choice. After they've picked odd or even, then I need to ask the user whether they want to throw an odd or even, if this is making sense. So we've got two different things happening here. One is them guessing the outcome. One is actually picking a number, and so the odd number we'll just say is one, or the even number is two. I suppose we could just pick any number, but since we're doing it on our hands, I guess it could be any number up to five, or maybe four for those of us who didn't fare so well in shop class. But anyway. So we have odd or even. Okay, so we'll just say a one or a two is basically what you're picking. Then we need to randomly pick the computer's choice, right? And then we're going to make some decisions. We're going to say we've got some different scenarios, right? We've got if the user chose odd, then we've got one situation happening. So if the user chose odd, then we have to decide, did they pick right? So how should we do this? And again, I'm just kind of making this up on the fly, so this isn't going to be perfection here. Hopefully you're kind of going through this process with me, so we might go back and change something. But I guess kind of what I was thinking is if they chose odd, And if the number was odd, then we want to print you win. And then we want to keep track of the number of wins. So we want to increment the user wins, let's say. Okay? All right, so what if the user chose odd and the number was even? Well, then we want to print the computer wins. And not increment the number of user wins, but we probably want to increment the number, the computer wins. So we can keep track of who's winning the best of this game, right? And then it's going to be the opposite, right? So if the user chose even, then we can say if the number was even, print you win, and then increment the number, or increment the user wins. If the number was odd, then print computer wins and increment the computer wins. Okay, so that's just kind of a first run at this, what's going to be happening in the program, and hopefully it's kind of all making sense. But just from, I don't know what, my gut programming experience, I don't like the idea that we're doing these multiple. I'm doing the same thing here as I'm doing here. Why can't I just create instead some winning scenarios and then just do this once? So there are a few ways that the user could win, right? And so I'm just thinking, looking at this, I don't really like this because it seems too repetitive. It seems like there's got to be an easier way to do this. And so maybe what I could do instead is come up with some winning scenarios. There's a winning scenario and there's a losing scenario, right? And so I'm going to just delete everything I did and instead try to come up with a winning scenario for the user. Okay, so if, what are some winning scenarios for the user? Well, if the user picked odd and the number was odd, that's one winning scenario. Or the user picked even and the number was even. Okay, so if that happened, either of those situations happened, then we can print user wins and then increment the number of wins. Okay, now we could just put an else on here. Else, if the user didn't win, then the computer won. But, and this just comes from years of probably bad programming. That just makes me a little bit nervous, because if I by chance did something wrong, then it's going to be acting like the computer won, but maybe the computer didn't actually win. So just, this is me, this is Spencer, you don't have to do it this way. I'm just going to build another if statement. And then if something goes wrong, it won't do either of them, and then I'll know it, right? Does that make sense? So if the user picked even and the number was odd, or the user picked odd and the number was even. If either of those situations happen, then I can print the computer wins and we increment the number of computer wins. And here I probably ought to specify user wins. And to me, this just looks a lot cleaner, because now we've got just one, that we're not doing the same thing again and again in the program. Okay, so what's next? Well, that's it, right? I mean, that's the game. They either win or lose. But I decided that before when I do this program, I want to play a best of series. And so this keeps track of the number of wins and whatnot. But I want to keep doing this for the number of wins, right? And so I have to make a decision here. I know I want to do it in a loop because I want to do it over and over and over again. But will I know how many times the user wants to play this game? What's the best of series? And the answer is, well, I don't unless I ask them. So before I do any of this, I could ask the user how many games they want to play. Okay, so once I have that, then I can play for the number of games that they've specified. Now all this will need to be indented to show that it's part of that for loop. Now I can do this for that number of games. I can keep playing over and over and over again for that number of games, and then when I get done playing that number of games, then I can print out the results. So I can print the number of user wins, print the number of computer wins, and then I can then I have to make a decision, right? If the user wins is greater than the computer wins, then what does that mean? I can print something like you won. And then same thing, I could use an else, but I might as well just use an if. If the user wins, wow, I'm having a hard time typing today, is less than the number of computer wins, then I can print computer won. And that's the logic of the game, right? That's all we're doing. We're going to ask them how many games they want to play, and then for that number of games we're going to play, and then we're going to ask the user whether they want to pick an odd or an even number. They think it's going to call it odd or even, right? And then ask the user whether they want to throw an odd number or an even number. And then randomly pick the computer's choice. Out of what, by the way? The computer can pick a 1 or a 2. If the user picked odd and the number was odd, or if the user picked even and the number was even, then the user wins. We increment the number of user wins. If the user picked even and the number was odd, or the user picked odd and the number was even, then we can print computer wins and then increment the number of computer wins. And we'll keep doing this. Sometimes I like to put a little note in here to say where I'm looping. In fact, in some syntax, you actually do put that loop keyword in there to tell where to loop. But that's what's going on. As we do this over and over and over again for the number of games, and when we get done, we can print the number of user wins, print the number of computer wins, and then decide who is it who won based on the outcome. Okay, so that's the logic. That's kind of where we're headed with the logic for the program. Now it's a matter of translating that to whatever language we're using. In this case, we're going to be using Java to actually build this program. And we'll do that in the next video. Spencer out.